This hour, more than 200 people are coming to Christine Blasey Ford's defense, the woman accusing Supreme Court nominee Brett Kavanaugh of sexual assault. The hundreds of supporters graduated from the same high school as Ford. And my next guest, Samantha Gary, is one of them. Samantha is joining us now. Thank you so much for being here with us. And you were just telling me before we got going here that you've known Christine Blasey Ford a long time.
40 years.
What is she like? And what do you think she's going through right now?
Well, this has been an agonizing period of time for her, as you might imagine. What she didn't ask to be in this position. She asked for confidentiality. And since that wasn't possible, apparently, we are now in the throes of being a political football. She's a very private person, and she's a very substantial woman of great intellect and integrity. She's a biostatistician, which is even hard for me to say, so I have great admiration for that alone. And she is someone who's really devoted her career to accuracy and data and facts. She's someone who doesn't put pen to paper unless she can prove it.
She knows the full weight of what she's alleging.
Absolutely.
And what she's doing.
Absolutely.
And what's your sense of what she's going to do? Because everybody is now waiting to see, is she going to testify? Is she going to come out publicly and talk about what she has said in this letter to the committee?
I don't know what she's going to do. I really don't. I think that she might not even know what she's going to do right now. This has all come on her very quickly since her name was released, and there are an awful lot of things coming at her right now. I think that the careful consideration she's giving to how she handles this should be a lesson to everyone involved in this process, that we all need to take a deep breath and consider how we're going to move forward with this information.
And I'm sure you've been listening to all the political debate over her coming forward and so on. A lot of the Republicans are complaining on the Judiciary Committee that this is an 11th hour, last ditch effort to derail Judge Kavanaugh's nomination, basically to get revenge for Merrick Garland and so on. Knowing Christine Blasey Ford personally, do you think she would be a part of that if that was what was going on?
Well, you know, I understand that this is highly inconvenient to the Republicans' agenda right now, but what Christine has done, she wasn't part of any of the decisions of how the information she put forward was handled. That's all been part of the Democrats having to really honor her decision to remain confidential. And, you know, whether it was revealed 2 months ago or last week, I'm not sure how relevant that is. I think that that's what we're focusing on right now, because that's, you know, sort of the dynamic that we're in. But regardless of the timing, we can't get sidetrack on that. We need to focus on the fact that this is a very serious allegation by a very substantive and credible person.
And you're seeing a lot of Republican senators, Bob Corker, Jeff Flake, now Susan Collins, coming forward and saying essentially that if she doesn't speak, if she doesn't talk to investigators, if she doesn't talk to the committee or speak publicly at this hearing, that they just need to move on and vote. What do you make of that?
I'm a little disappointed to hear that. She has said that she will talk to investigators. But my understanding is that having the proper FBI investigation would be only done at the request of Trump. And I'm not sure how likely that is, which really puts Christine in a very uncomfortable position, because appearing in a public forum in front of thousands of cameras and people and Congress people, it just seems really like an inappropriate forum for this kind of discussion, at least for the next step. And we've already seen that done. I mean, no one can say that the Anita Hill hearings were a great success. So
She doesn't want to go through the same thing that Anita Hill went.
Why would you want to go through that? She doesn't want to go through what she's going through now. This is a really traumatic experience on top of a traumatic experience.
And do you know Brett Kavanaugh at all?
I did. He was an acquaintance of mine in high school.
And did he have this reputation for excessive drinking during that time?
I can't really speak to that because
he wasn't
directly...
What about what Dr. Ford is alleging? Was this the first time you had heard anything like that with respect to Judge Kavanaugh?
Absolutely. It was not the first time I've heard anything like that in terms of the community of women that I know, and not regarding him, but...
Those sorts of things went on.
A lot. You know, one of the things that's been surprising to me as I've gotten involved in this in the last couple of days is how many women of my class have come forward to me in this last few days and said, I had similar experiences in high school, and this hits me very deeply, and it's very...
Not with Brett Kavanaugh, but with other boys.
Not with Brett Kavanaugh, but with other boys in our community, and we all feel that if we were in her shoes, we'd want to be taken seriously as well.
Okay. Well, we appreciate your time very much, Samantha Gary. Thank you very much, and obviously your friend has a big story to tell. We're all waiting to see what happens, but thank you very much for sharing what you have to say.
Thank you for listening.
Good talking to you. We appreciate it.